Use the diagram. Find the coordinates of F, the midpoint of segment OC. Show that segment FD is parallel to segment BC and the length of segment FD equals 1/2 times the length of segment BC. To find the coordinates of F, first plot F on the graph as the midpoint of segment OC. Now, because F is a midpoint, you can find the coordinates of F using the midpoint formula. Let x1 equal 0, y1 equal 0, x2 equal 2p, and y2 equal 0. You can substitute these values into the midpoint formula. When you simplify, 0 plus 2p gives you 2p, and 0 plus 0 gives you 0. 2p divided by 2 gives you p, and 0 divided by 2 gives you 0. So, the coordinates of F are P, 0. Next, you need to find the coordinates of D. In the diagram, segment DE is a midsegment. So, point D is the midpoint of segment OB. Therefore, you can find the coordinates of D using the midpoint formula. Let x1 equal 0, y1 equal 0, x2 equal 2q, and y2 equal 2r. You can substitute these values into the midpoint formula. When you simplify, 0 plus 2q gives you 2q, and 0 plus 2r gives you 2r. 2q divided by 2 gives you q, and 2r divided by 2 gives you r. So, the coordinates of D are q, r. Now, two segments are parallel if they have the same slope. So, to show that segment FD is parallel to segment BC, you need to show that they have the same slope. You can find the slope of each segment using the slope formula. To find the slope of segment FD, let x1 equal p, y1 equal 0, x2 equal q, and y2 equal r. You can substitute these values into the slope formula. When you simplify, r minus 0 gives you r in the numerator. So, the slope of segment FD is r divided by the quantity q minus p. To find the slope of segment BC, let x1 equal 2p, y1 equal 0, x2 equal 2q, and y2 equal 2r. You can substitute these values into the slope formula. When you simplify, 2r minus 0 gives you 2r in the numerator. Next, notice that each term in the denominator has a factor of 2. So, you can factor out a 2 from each term in the denominator. Now, because there is a factor of 2 in both the numerator and the denominator, you can divide out this common factor, leaving you with r divided by the quantity q minus p. So, the slope of segment BC is r divided by the quantity q minus p. Now, as you can see, both segments have a slope of r divided by the quantity q minus p. Therefore, because they have the same slope, segment FD is parallel to segment BC. Finally, to show that the length of segment FD is equal to 1/2 times the length of segment BC, you need to find the length of each segment using the distance formula. To find the length of segment FD, again, let x1 equal p, y1 equal 0, x2 equal q, and y2 equal r. You can substitute these values into the distance formula. When you simplify, r minus 0 quantity squared gives you r squared. So, the length of segment FD is equal to the square root of the quantity q minus p quantity squared plus r squared. To find the length of segment BC, again, let x1 equal 2p, y1 equal 0, x2 equal 2q, and y2 equal 2r. You can substitute these values into the distance formula. Now, to simplify, you can first factor out a 2 from each term in the quantity 2q minus 2p. Next, 2 times the quantity q minus p quantity squared gives you 4 times q minus p quantity squared, and 2r minus 0 quantity squared gives you 4r squared. Now, notice that both terms and the quantity inside the radical have a factor of 4. So, you can factor out a 4 from each term. Next, you can rewrite this as the square root of 4 times the square root of the quantity q minus p quantity squared plus r squared. And the square root of 4 is 2. So, the length of segment BC is equal to 2 square roots of the quantity q minus p quantity squared plus r squared. Now, notice that the square root of the quantity q minus p quantity squared plus r squared is equal to 1/2 times 2 square roots of the quantity q minus p quantity squared plus r squared. Therefore, the length of segment FD is equal to 1/2 times the length of segment BC.